Big Macs, and pizza rolls. Those are just a list of a few things that the American people eat on a regular basis. Do you remember when you were younger and feeling ecstatic and delighted when you got to eat any one of these foods? Do you remember thinking, why do I become so happy and so thrilled of eating these foods? The author of Sugar Controversy states that the average American people eats roughly 101 pounds of sugar each year. The American people are addicted to sugar. There are many studies out there that show how sugar intake can cause health problems and weight gain if the individual isn't active enough. Marisa Clement states, Americans aren't benefiting when their diets only consist of sugar and high-calorie diets, and today I'm going to inform you on how American is causing obesity. Clement states, in order for businesses to survive, they need artificial or processed foods. The reason manufacturers do this is because it's easier for poorer families. Take an orange for an example. They are a perishable fruit, which means they can't be frozen or saved. So squeezing the juice out of the orange will keep it from getting old or preserving the fruit. When you take away the fiber in the fruits, or orange, you're replacing it with sugar. What the companies are doing is when they're replacing the fiber with sugar, they're making a higher profit. If you're a diabetic and whose blood sugars are low, juice is a quick and easy way to get your sugars to increase. This process can also trigger an I'm full signal because the fiberless drink flows through the body faster than through your intestine. Michael Moss, the author of Salt, Sugar, Fat, How the Food Giants Hooked Us, mentioned in Robert King's policy debate states that companies at high levels of sugar, salt, and fat content in a conscious effort. This gets people hooked on the convenient and inexpensive foods, especially for the poorer families. Keener states people that are finally waking up and asking how their food is processed, marketed, and the government agencies are starting to limit the sugary sodas to help the school lunch dietary guidelines. Studies found that American teens were in 2013 exercising more, watching less TV, and eating more fruits and vegetables compared to the same age child in 2001. High fructose corn syrup is a new and cheap replacement for cane sugar. The reason they started using high fructose corn syrup was to better farm and marketing and family budgets, but it wasn't helping people's health in the years after. Because of the new low cost of the companies, it makes sugary food cheaper than foods with sugar cane. This just doesn't cause weight change, but also health changes as well. The increase of added sugars and oils, or fats, has increased heart disease and diabetes. Susan Strait says in the article that in many places, there aren't an abundance of healthy food available to the community. People in low-income families have a high risk of becoming obese. In states like Alabama, Arkansas, Iowa, Louisiana, Mississippi, Oklahoma, and West Virginia, the obesity rate is more noticeable in the rural areas. Policymakers, schools, and private companies are voluntarily trying to remove the high calorie count in their products. Then, in turn, they receive funding. Research from Stanford University reported that people are making an effort to reduce the sugar, grains, and highly processed foods instead of counting calories, and they've seen significant amounts of weight loss in over a year. In Mark Ferris's research, he states the idea that organic eating is better for you, although there isn't any clear-cut evidence pointing towards the facts. Studies have shown organically grown food has high nutrients, antioxidants, healthy fatty acids, and are significantly lower in pesticide residue. Even though Ferris stands with this evidence, he states that there isn't enough evidence that organic has more nutrients. Barbara Mantle, author of Preventing Obesity, states, one way of reducing your body fat is reducing carbohydrates and high fats constantly. There are many ways of Americans have tried to lose weight, like counting your calories, but this method hasn't shown very much results. The most effective way researchers have found that helps people lose weight is write down and focus on monitoring your behaviors rather than a specific diet. The challenge for the U.S. Congress is regulating or finding the best way to monitor the safety of the foods coming into the states. Victoria Finkel states in her article that the number of incidents associated with imported foods is slowly increasing. This could cause a problem because in order to decrease the potential outbreaks, companies need to inject chemicals into the foods to keep them safe for the people. Americans aren't saying enough that is enough in cutting out their extreme amounts of sugar intake. They also need to take the effects of the imported goods. The American government has been regulating or trying to regulate the amount of imported goods that come from Mexico or China, especially with meat, because it has a lot of unknown chemicals or bacteria that can harm the economy or community. All America needs is a drive and understanding of the benefits and consequences of their personal diets. All they need is the information to make a better lifestyle choices. So now the next time you look at a Big Mac or a Twinkie, you'll know how it'll affect your body, and in the long run, you'll be glad you'll know.